We have something of a quandary. Well, you know Bob, the warm-up comedian. We call him a comedian. He's not really a comedian. Well, he normally wears a hat, but look behind you. He's not wearing a hat. Check it out. Go check it out. He's definitely not wearing a hat, is he? No, no, definitely not. So, Bob, you're the warm-up comedian. Now, we call you a comedian.
He's not really a comedian.
Not really,
not really a comedian. No.
But we always say that, but Bob is, in fact, a comedian.
He is truly a comedian.
Yeah, you are a comedian, actually, Bob.
I try, yeah.
All right, all right.
There.
Do jokes.
Yeah,
comedian. It's horrible when people do that.
I know.
They go, do jokes.
I know, it happens a lot. And I don't have any. That's why it sometimes makes me sad.
Isn't he adorable? America is going to learn to love you, hatless Bob, if you don't mind me calling him that.
I genuinely love
I know. I, Bob hates him when he doesn't wear a hat, and I could tell he was uncomfortable. I thought, this is the night.
There you go.
Now, why are you worried about your not having a hat, Bob? Any insecurities?
Yeah, there's there's a little bit of a glow from the lights, yeah. But it was my lucky Mythbusters hat.
Oh.
Yes.
Given to you by?
I stole it from
Oh, well, that...
wasn't given by anyone. Good,
so a lucky. So that means tonight's show is going to suck.
I didn't want to.
Jeff, how would that be?
Business as usual.
You ever seen Bob without a hat in your life?
Yeah, I've seen Bob without clothes.
Oh. You know, I frown on inter-office romance.
Well, I'm a robot, so it's okay.
What about you? You ever seen Bob without his hat? When? Over there?
Yeah.
You've seen Bob without his hat over there?
It's excellent. It's true.
Okay, were you once over there without your hat?
I was. And he was there. And it's.
And you were there. Well, that sounds crazy. I wish I'd been there. Oh, gosh. I wish you had your lucky Mythbusters hat. I have a feeling tonight's show might suck.
No. We can do this. It'll be great.
What about you? You ever seen Bob without his hat?
Oh, yeah. I saw him, over there.
There's a lot of stuff going on.
Over there, back there.
Good times.
Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Nationwide.
Nationwide is on your side.
Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
But I am staggering from the volume of that. Did you hear the warm-up comedian tonight?
Yeah, sure.
Well, we call him a comedian.
Yeah, he's not really a comedian.
Not really
That's
a comedian.
No, he's not.
But he said, make him stagger from your volume.
Yeah, blow him with your wind.
Yeah, blow him. Yeah. He said, blow him, pound him. I was like, I'm coming. Yeah.
Well, that
I'll
happens
be right
after.
Out.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Dance for the man, monkey. That's the way.
Did you call me a monkey?
No, it was just a symbolic thing.
A symbolic monkey. Yeah. Much like the real monkey that Justin Bieber left in Germany.
Justin Bieber's now German.
Yeah, I've haven't forgotten. I know I go on and on about it, but who's going to defend the German adopted monkeys of the world if not I? All right, it's a great day for America, everybody. It is. Although a sad day as we hear that America's sweethearts, the Honey Boo Boo family, Mama June and Sugar Bear, are separating.
Yeah.
It's very sad. They're not consciously uncoupling. That's for people who eat kale. Mama June and Sugar Bear, and I quote, ha diddly ha da ding dong broke toe. Is that right?
Holy ding dong dong ding dong dong dong.
Apparently, Mama June caught Sugar Bear cheating with other women. I know. They were Betty Crocker, Mrs. Butterworth, Little Debbie, Sarah Lee, and Jemima. You get any?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, Mr. Clean, Jolly Green Giant.
Oh, well, no, they're dudes.
I've been with those guys.
Okay. You see, the Secret Service is in a bit of trouble after a man jumped a fence and entered the White House. In their defense, though, they said when they saw a crazed maniac running across the lawn, they thought it was Biden. So I think... Ooh, I love trains! Here in L.A., the weather has finally cooled down. It's very cool, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
How cool is it?
Oh, it is so cool.
So cool, I can start wearing my long-sleeve Speedos. You get any?
Yeah, I like when you wear those, actually.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, yeah.
You get any It's So Cool things?
No, that's all I got. That's it.
Scientists have said that this summer was the hottest summer in Earth's history, and they came to a definitive conclusion after Larry King said, yep, that's true. It's never been hotter.
Right. Because he, yeah. That's good, yeah.
That's my Larry King.
Yeah, it's good, yeah, Larry, yeah. Because he's really old, so he's been around.
Ah, nah, it's just, you pick a mannerism that he doesn't have and then exaggerate it.
Yeah, I get it.
That's how I work.
That's your thing.
Yeah, yeah, but this is how I get an impression of someone. You know, I say, well, he never does that, so I'll do that, and then say it's him.
Perfect.
Do you remember when I did Obama and all we could do was a French accent?
That was very good, yeah.
Hello, I'm president. Yes, I can.
It's uncanny, man.
It's nothing like President Obama at all, but it's the one characteristic I choose to give him, you know, see.
I'll do my impression of you real quick.
Okay.
See? Nothing like you at all.
That is a bit like
me. It is a bit.
All right. It's a big anniversary today. 20 years ago today, the first episode of Friends was broadcast. I never forget my first. Do you remember the...
Oh, yeah.
I remember my first Rachel...
Yeah.
Do you have a picture of me when I first... Yeah, there you are. That kind of looks good.
So good.
That kind of looks good.
Really nice.
I kind of like that. Let me see that again. I'm going to do that. See, next year, that's the way I'm going to roll.
It really compliments your chin. It's very nice.
My chin?
Yeah, it's very nice.
Let me see it again.
Look at this. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Yeah. Looks like I've been eating corn or something, doesn't it? Anyway, earlier tonight on Fox, there was a new show, Gotham. It's about when Batman was a little boy and Robin was a little girl.
Boom.
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 Do we have a picture of Batman as a little boy? Yeah, Batboy. There you are. And for some reason, he's with Kate Middleton.
Yeah.
What the hell? I think we're just trying to get through all the pictures before December. Yeah, I think that's what it is. Yeah, I'd hang on to that. I think we'll probably be using that again.
I like that one. Yeah,
I kind of like that one. Yeah, anyway, that's it. We're done.
That's it. We're finished.
Yep, all over.
You just want to get out of here now, or what do you want to... You want to do this show and then go, or what do you want to...
I don't know. Maybe if the audience blow and pound me with their enthusiasm. Maybe I'll show you. Generic music we don't have to pay for.
Cost of
library music that is not copyrighted.
Because they give us $5 to do this show.
How much do you think the budget is for this show?
There's no budget.
There's no
for
budget.
This show.
Come on. All right, Jeff, let's we just practice. One ding.
We are German.
Two dings.
We are still German.
Three dings.
We are Dracula.
Dracula. Four dings.
Italian Bill Clinton.
What's the coming to go?
Yeah.
Five dings.
Room service.
Hello?
Hello, sir. It's Jerry from room service.
Jerry! Hello, it's room service.
Feeling good, feeling good. Feeling,
no,
feeling
it's room, this is room service.
No, room service. Oh, my God, I didn't realize I called room service. This is quite a conundrum, sir. Quite a conundrum.
So you're talking very quickly, Jerry. What's going on?
I'm on cocaine right now.
Oh, Jerry. You're on cocaine.
I'd like to order a ham sandwich and bring a couple of guys up, nicely greased, well-oiled, and I'd like to be blown and pounded by the studio audience.
Here's how I know you're not on cocaine. You asked for a ham sandwich.
Yeah, you got me again, sir. You got me again.
Yeah, you were just joshing with me, weren't you?
Yeah, good name, sir. Good name.
Yeah,
strong
good name,
name
Josh. Name. You know, I've always found in my life, and I mean no disrespect to any Joshes out there, but any Josh I've ever met is a complete douche.
Oh, that's interesting, because most Craigs I know are...
Tootsie Frootsie.
Is that right?
Except for one. That Craig Kilborn, he was really...
Oh, hey.
Click, click, click.
Are you hanging up?
I tried. It wouldn't hang up, sir.
All right, well, never call this number again.
You got it.
See you later.
Click.
Well, I hope that puts an end to... Oh, wait, no, it's Monday. It's Celebrity Call-In Monday.
Oh, Celebrity Call-In Monday.
Oh, I wonder who's going to call in. Hello, welcome to Celebrity Call-In Monday. Please be a celebrity.
It's Liam Neeson. How are you?
Liam Neeson! I went to see your movie last week, yeah. A Walk Amongst the Tombstones. It was awesome.
It's a great film. I hope you enjoyed it. Is it the best film you've ever seen in your life? Answer carefully or I'll kill you.
Thanks for calling Celebrity Call-In Monday.
Can I get a ham sandwich?
That's how you know he's not on cocaine.
Ah. Right. I would like a ham sandwich.
That's how you know you're not on cocaine.
Okay. Right. Oh, trust me, you'd know.
Yeah. Oh.
Hello, who's calling Celebrity Call-In Mondays?
Craig, it's Dr. Oz. And listen, I just want to talk to you very quickly because if you eat a ham sandwich and you're on cocaine at the same time, it's going to help you out. What it's going to do, it's going to increase the gluten in your system. And you're going to find out that that's going to really bring down the high. And then you're going to...
Time is Jeremy Pearson.
Yeah. Tweet mail time. Let's do it.
Play the jingle. Yeah.
Duck and cover and don't look back. Here comes an email and Twitter attack. Monsters crushing our city. It's a jumbo lizard wrecking committee. So grab your ray gun and your rocket back and join the email Twitter attack!
All right, this is from David in Mesa, Arizona. You ever been there?
David, yes. David, yeah.
You've been to David?
I've been to David, yep.
David says, Craig, is it too late in the year to barbecue on the weekend in white pants? Not in Arizona, it's not.
No.
It's going to be hot. How hot is it going to be, Jeff?
It is so hot.
This is from Bettina in Yuma, Arizona. You ever been there?
Bettina, you know it.
Actually, you know what? Bettina is actually a very small bet.
A very small bet.
Yeah, if you go to Vegas and you don't want to put too much down, you go, I'm not going to make a bet. I'll just make a bettina.
That's right, yeah.
Just a couple of bucks. A bettina.
All right. The Scottish lesbian makes a bettina. That's good. All right, here we go. All right, all bets are in.
Wait. Where did the lesbian thing come from?
I don't know. That's what we've called you for all these years.
No, we've called me Liza Minnelli.
Yeah,
we've never called me a lesbian.
Yeah, you said you had a lesbian haircut. You've said that many times.
You may have said it many times.
No, you've said it. I've heard it. I stood here and I heard it.
And anyway, lesbians have many and varied haircuts. Check out Lesbian Row, for example. Now look, some have got long hair, some have got short hair. There's one at the end with a beard. Come on!
That's a dude.
Yeah. That's a dude. You know, I'm beginning to think that they just let anyone sit in lesbian role.
I know, I know.
That role was specifically put there for lesbians. And I'm talking genuine lesbians, not pretend ones from porn. Real lesbians.
Right. So now you girls have to prove that you're lesbian.
No, you don't.
Right now. Right now.
Bettina says, Craig, do you collect comic books growing up? And if you did, what was your favorite? Ugh, shut up.
Man.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, my favorite was Trousers Man.
That was a good one. Trousers Man. Big fan of that one.
Trousers Man, yeah.
Sure.
Oh, did you see people dressed up as Trousers Man at Comic-Con?
Oh, it was unbelievable.
Oh, it was crazy. They were all walking around wearing trousers.
We're good.
No, Trousers Man is... the wind's blowing him away. Oh, Trousers God. Man... Trousers Man, what was his superpower again?
He had power in his pockets. He had lint.
Yeah, that's
in his
right.
Pockets.
Power. He had power. What was it? He had a rocket in his pocket.
That's right. That's right.
He had a rocket in his pocket, and he was always happy to see.
That's right. And his favorite game was pocket pool. That's
pocket
true.
Pool. That's true. Right.
That's true.
And what just did that? What the hell was that? Well, we're out of time. Oh, so you have a sign now for We're Out of Time? Hey, I got a sign for We're Out of Time. What about that?
Yeah. Yeah. There you go.
Is that sign okay?
Hey, come on.
Is that sign okay? you know, it's because we were talking about Trousers Man. You are a racist.
That's
the problem.
Racist. He's doing it. What is this, X Factor? Is he a judge?
I know. It's like we're out of time and safe. We're in a commercial. What's wrong with you? Oh. Hello?
It's Trousers Man.
Ah! We gotta go. Found your lucky MythBusters hat. Look. Yeah, we found it. Think somebody's got a new hat. You can't pick it up, boy. You've got hooves. All right. My first guest, a very, very talented actor. His movie, The Skeleton Twins, is in theaters now. Please welcome the lovely Bill Hader, everybody. Bill Hader. The film, is it good?
Yeah,
it's a good movie. It's a serious movie, though.
The Skeleton Twins.
Yeah.
It's a serious movie. Yeah, Kristen Wiig and I play estranged twins.
Skeletons?
No. Sorry.
You've been very excited about this movie for a long time.
Yeah, because Skeleton Twins was the name of my testicles, so I'm very excited. Very excited about that.
All right, now get off. He's white.
I'm sorry. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
I can't even play along with it. No, it's based on a book about your testicles.
Right, thank you.
And Kristen and I play the right one.
Thank you for acknowledging that, Bill Hader. I appreciate
it. You're welcome.
Thank you.
You don't have to acknowledge him, man. I mean, I appreciate it, but it's all right. Now, tell me the story of the movie. What is it? Well, not all of it, because I have to see it.
Well, the ending were ghosts.
Oh, no.
I can remember.
Oh.
No, No.
You were ghost sold.
We imagine if yeah, Bruce Willis came on doing Sixth Sense. He's like, well, at the end, I'm a ghost.
That would be terrible. Wait, is that what happens? Oh, come on, man. I haven't seen that movie.
Kevin Spacey's like, well, I'm Kaiser Sose.
Yeah. And then at the end of, what was it, The Crying Game, when it was like, oh, it's a dude.
Yeah.
Like, oh, never guessed that one.
Well, I play a girl at the first part of the movie.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Let's get serious.
Well, it's a serious movie.
It's a serious film. Actually, it is. Yeah, it's a drama that Krista and I did. But it is very funny. We thought we made this very sweet kind of drama, but we were really surprised that when people see it, it's actually a big crowd pleaser. People were laughing and clapping.
Do you hang around in movie theaters when?
Yeah.
Like, you're like, don't pay no attention to me. I introduced the movie. Oh, you do?
I go to every theater. Yeah, I just got back from Minnesota. I was like, all right, everybody, hey, I'm here. Pretend I'm not here. But if you don't laugh, I'll be really mad.
You know that Anthony Hopkins used to do that with Silence of the Lambs? He did it. He told me himself right here.
No, he did.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah. What would he do? He was after a Silence of the Lambs. He was in one screening, and he watched it. At the end of it, there was a lady sitting in front of him who was like freaking out. At the end, he went, "Did you enjoy the movie?" Isn't that great?
Oh,
I love that movie.
Oh, I love that movie. You know, SNL, actually, we tried to do, you know, the back Jamie Gumm, Buffalo Bill in that movie?
Yeah.
At SNL, we tried to do the Jamie Gumm talk show.
Oh, where that I played would be Jamie awesome. Gumm,
where I was like, hey, everybody, it's me, the Jamie Gumm talk show.
Oh, man, oh, that's
she a great big fat person.
Like, it was all that. And then our my co-host was the woman in the well that you never saw. It was just a shot of the well. And it's like, today on the show, we got, the, you know, whatever.
And we Why didn't that ever be there?
We did it at the table read. I remember Seth Meyers and John Mulaney and I wrote it. We did a table read, and it was just it was like, oh, guys, come on.
That is a great idea.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, no, you get Seth. You get over here yourself. Let's do it here.
All right, I'll do it here.
Let's do it. That is a great idea.
I love it.
Because if you know anything about this show, you know we don't give it.
Crikey.
So let's do it. I met Seth for the first time last week.
Yeah, I know. You're great.
What a lovely man.
No, you gave him some good advice.
I was like, But a very nice man.
Really sweet guy. You know, he taught me so much at that show. Yeah.
That must be a great place to learn.
Crikey.
Oh, my God. Yeah. That's what Lauren says. Like, this is a great place to learn.
Ooh la la!
Yeah.
Crikey. I had a meeting with him once.
Really?
Yeah, when I started doing this show, I thought, I'd like to meet Lauren Michaels. And I thought, now I've got a show, he'll meet me. And he did.
He did?
Yeah.
How did it go?
It was all right. We sat for about 45 minutes. I'm Scottish, he's Canadian. We said, all right. And he went, all right. And then, we both awkwardly shuffled for a bit. And then I hugged him, and he fainted. I get it, you know.
Oh, yeah.
But a very talented man.
Obviously,
powerful as well.
Yeah. No, he gave me a career. So
yeah.
I would not be sitting here.
He gave yourself a career.
I would not be sitting here if Lauren went, you know.
Is that what it does? Does he go around scouting?
Yeah, he just walks around. I was on the street, and he went, you. And I was like, excuse me? And he went, you.
Where were you before Saturday Night Live?
I was here in Los Angeles. I was an assistant editor on Iron Chef America.
Man, you were almost there.
I was almost there. I was almost there. Oh, yeah.
What the hell did you end up doing that?
I was doing improv theater and stuff here in L.A. at Second City, and Megan Mullally saw me in a show and recommended me to Lorne Michaels. Changed my whole life. So I was sitting there as an assistant editor on Iron Chef America.
And he came into the room?
That would be amazing. Lorne went, you. And then he got a rope ladder and a helicopter took him away.
Yeah.
Like a Bond villain. I got a phone call saying Megan Mullally recommended you to us. And
you go and have an audition in that show?
Yeah.
How long were you on that show?
8 years.
Good Lord, that's way too long.
Yeah.
That's way too long. Yeah.
And I'm going back to host.
You going back to host?
I'm hosting
the show. Oh, that's great.
Yeah,
man.
October 11th. Yeah. I'm hosting the show October 11th. Yeah. So I get to do that.
Now, when you're hosting it, do you get to boss the other people around? You used to.
No, well, you get to. Well, no, but you get to go into the room where that you do our table read on Wednesdays, and then everyone would go into Lauren's office and close the door, and I never knew what happened in that room where they picked the show. I never knew what that was like.
And now
I get to go into that room, and when Kristen Wiig hosted, she went in, she came out, and I was like, "What's it like in there?" And she's like, "I can't tell you." So now
it's
I get
going
to go
to be
in.
Weird. No, they'll pour you a goblet of blood and say, "And now you must drink. One of us.
One of us."
Yeah. We have to take a break.
Uh-oh.
You know, just one of
oh, that's what you do on shows. Oh, right.
Yeah. You're going to have to remember that for Saturday Night Live.
I know.
Because, you know, they're live, much like this show. We'll be right back with Bill Hader. We're out of time, Bill. We're out of time.
We're out of time?
Yeah, we're out of time.
All right.
I just came back to tease you. No. We have a little bit of time.
Really?
Oh, just a little, I guess. What do you want to do?
What do I want to do now?
Yeah, what do you want to do now? Want to have some fun?
Yeah, what do you want to do?
All right, want to pretend... let's pretend I'm a therapist and you're Bill Hader.
Okay.
All right. Why do you think you're sexually attracted to mice?
Oh. I could tell you, Tom and Jerry when I was a child. And
the mouse would scuttle towards the
door. The mouse would scuttle towards the door and I would say, "My God, I love it. The hindquarters, big doughy eyes." And I would say, "You must be mine."
Well, now as you say it like that, I find myself also sexually attracted. What do you say we get out of here and find some mice?
Let's go find them.
Bill Hader, everybody.
Thank you.
Future, you'll be able to say to your friends, "I was there the night the horse started wearing the Mythbusters hat." My next guest is one of the stars of NCIS, NCIS, NCIS. It's on a big show.
Big show.
NCIS New Orleans, which is premiering tomorrow night at 9 on CBS. Take a look at this. Scott Bakula, everybody. Scott Bakula. For me, I can't tell you what a pleasure it is for me to meet you. I've been a fan of yours for a very, very long time. I'm
Thank
very
you.
Much a fan of you. I love you, and I like your name because it sounds like Dracula.
Yes, and it's and I believe that's three dings on the bell,
three
if
dings,
I'm not mistaken.
No, three dings is oh yeah, three dings
yes,
is Dracula.
It is, yes.
Yeah, right. I think so.
But you got it wrong. It's yeah.
Dracula.
Yeah.
No, no, it's three dings. No. Bakula.
Yeah.
There you go.
Very good.
Yeah.
Very good. It is pronounced like that, though, isn't it?
It is.
Do people pronounce it the wrong way a lot?
Only my whole life.
Bakula.
Bakula.
Yeah.
Dracula.
Yeah.
Bakula.
You ever been to Transylvania?
No, I have not.
You've got to go.
I know. My family comes from there.
No.
Yes.
A big castle?
Big castle.
Go up to the Bakula Castle. It's right next to the Dracula Castle?
Yes.
They're just next to it. They're fine. No, don't worry about the Baculas. They're nice. It's Dracula, you know. Baculas, they're so much fun.
Yes. We changed our name very early.
Probably for the best.
Yeah.
What is the name from? What is it?
It's outside of Prague. It's Czech. Bohemia.
Really?
Actually, yeah.
So it is kind of Dracula, Bakula.
It not kind of. It is.
It is. All right.
Yeah.
All right.
But you're safe.
For now.
For now.
Yeah. Tell me about the NCIS New Orleans show. Is it a detective show set in New Orleans?
It's You've been to New Orleans. You know what it's like.
I have.
Down there,
I love
right?
it down there.
Do
and
you?
Also in New Orleans. Do you like New Orleans?
Yeah, I do. I love it. It's very hot. The food is great. The music's awesome.
Do you have an oyster?
I've had many oysters, yeah. Do you like oysters?
No, sir.
Why?
I don't care for them.
Why?
I don't know. It's like little salty snot balls going down your...
So you don't like to chew snotty salt balls? Is that...
You know, weird as it sounds, no, I don't. Have you eaten them a lot before you went to New Orleans?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I see. Do you use them for their aphrodisiac qualities? You do?
Of course.
Really?
Yes.
Do you think that's true?
He's got the hat on. Ask him.
Do you think that's true?
It's a myth buster.
No? Yeah. That is true. Yes.
Yes.
You really think
yes.
so?
Yes. I had a half dozen before I came out.
Get the room service.
Yeah. Oh, look at that.
Hello. Is this Mr. Bakula?
Close enough.
Yeah, getting kind of worked up over here. I heard you're worked up, too. You want to touch the skeleton twins?
All right.
What the hell's going on over there?
All right. I can't believe that.
Oh, man.
You can't treat people like that. I'm so sorry.
It's all right.
I'm so sorry. Do you make the show down in New Orleans? Well, you make some of it there and some of it here,
We're making it all down there.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a great place to be. I'd love to be there all the time. Have you been there for Mardi Gras?
I have not yet.
It gets a little crazy.
I've heard that. In fact, weren't you there a couple of years ago for Mardi Gras? Or like during Super Bowl time?
Yeah, Super Bowl and Mardi Gras and something else all fixed together. I saw more boobies than you could...
I saw you throwing candy out, and I thought you're throwing beads out.
Well,
there.
Sometimes I throw candy out here, and occasionally somebody takes the hint. But
it's beads.
It's beads. Yeah.
Beads. You're throwing the wrong stuff.
Well, yeah, I know, but you've never done that.
You should
do it.
Well, if we're lucky enough, we'll be shooting there during that time, and or we'll leave town. I'm not sure which one.
The thing is, when you see some of the boobies, you're like, I wish I'd kept my beads to myself.
That's the.
yeah, it's like that. Like,
yeah, no. Oh, no.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, yeah.
Now, where are you from originally?
St. Louis. I'm upriver.
All right. So you're familiar with the neighborhood. You've been down there before, right?
I went down there a couple of years ago for the first time, so I didn't know anything about it. I actually was there during Super Bowl time, just before then.
Really?
Yeah.
Because
it's
famous vampire country as well?
Very much. Well, then my family, we have several crypts down there, yes. Yes. Tom Cruise is in one of them. And, it's...
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, I don't get the Tom Cruise. Yes, no, I do get the Tom Cruise.
That was way too. That was,
fine.
Over the river and
fine. So you're sexually attracted to mice?
Yes, absolutely. Yes. Yeah, I chased Bill Hader right out.
Have you ever hosted Saturday Night Live?
No, I haven't. You know,
I would have thought you would have.
You know what he said to me when I auditioned for that show years and years ago?
Lauren?
Yeah.
What did he say?
He said, not you.
You auditioned for that show?
Yes, I was stupid.
You must have.
I was cleverly stupid.
That must have been a long time ago.
It was a long time. The show's been on a while.
Yeah, that's true.
Yes, not 10 years like some other shows.
Oh, geez, yeah, no, man. You, that's way too long.
That's amazing.
How long were you? Quantum Leap was on for a long time.
No, 4.5 years.
Really? Well, it's because of the time change.
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, it was kind of on for like 40 years.
That was a great show.
Thank you.
That was a great show.
It was fun.
They ever talk about making a movie of that?
Yeah, they talk about it all the time.
I would love to see a movie of that.
You should produce it.
I will. I got nothing else to do. I'll do it. Yeah.
You could be in it.
Yeah. No, nobody wants that. But
they could.
Well, maybe just a you. Yeah, I could do that. He's gone that way.
I could leap into your body.
Yeah, no, I think that would be a great idea for a movie. There must be scripts lying around for it.
They've talked about it for years. The last big feedback was that we can't market it, so they can't market the title.
Quantum Leap?
Yes. Yeah.
Everybody knows what it is.
Well, I guess that's the problem.
Yeah, I guess.
Nothing to do.
There's no surprise there.
Nothing to do here, everyone.
Well, gosh, that's odd. Yeah, well.
No, it happens.
Well, let's see if we can't fix that.
Get to work.
All right,
time, as you
yes,
said.
I have. Yes. I'll make it happen.
Yes.
Yeah.
Really?
All right.
Well, that's easy.
Get that sorted out, will you?
So when does
that... that sorting out?
Yeah, oh, it's Michael over there. He's a racist, but he's a...
He just said no.
He just said no.
Yes, a negative racist.
Too difficult to market? Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
That's right, yeah. You bastard.
Can you give the finger on television?
It depends. I think it like if you leave other fingers around it, it's cool.
Oh, yeah, I see.
But once you start like that's still cool. And I think that is probably still cool. But the pixelation machine will kick in right around there.
It's so weird, isn't it?
It is.
Isn't it a weird thing?
I don't understand it. I really do. I genuinely don't understand it. But hey, you know, I'm just a foreigner with a dream. Well, we're out of time, Scott.
Well, there you go.
Yeah.
Dream achieved, though. I would.
I think so.
I would say so.
These are two things that I've taken away from this. You got to get yourself to Transylvania and check out the old country.
Yes.
And. I was doing that.
Yes, I saw.
Yeah.
Wait, what's this?
What's that?
Inside there?
That's a tattoo.
Is that New Orleans?
No.
What the?
I got tattoos in New Orleans. Yeah. Do you have any tattoos?
No, I don't.
Well, you need some. Now, there's a tattoo. There's a great tattoo parlor in New Orleans called Electric Ladyland Tattoo. Yeah. And where is it again? Do you remember? It's down some street with a guy playing a trumpet. You go down there and you ask for Ed. Ed will give you a good tattoo. He did some on me.
Yeah?
And also gave me a tattoo.
You play, not trumpet, what is it I hear?
I used to play the drums a little bit.
No, I thought I heard about you play trombone, is that true?
Well, I Do you?
I don't know, no, I don't.
Oh, you don't?
No, I
only keep a rusty trombone under my desk in order to say rusty trombone. The only way you're allowed to say it is if you actually have one in front of you.
Set up.
Yeah, I know. Anyway, we gotta go. Beautiful. Scott Bakula, everybody.
Oh my.
Well, I think what we learned is that Bob, the warm-up comedian, we call him a comedian, Jeff.
Yeah, he's not really a comedian.
Not really a comedian. Well, he is, really. Do some jokes. Bob used to have a Lucky Mythbusters hat. And now Secretariat has a Lucky Mythbusters hat. And that's how life goes. It's all right.
Could I replace it with a Late Late Show hat?
Do we have Late Late Show hats?
I haven't seen
it. We don't have Late Late Show hats? No. See, this is why I get so upset.
Hey, man.
Why don't we have Late Late Show hats? Now that I haven't thought about it ever.
Well, what's the answer?
We don't have them. Oh, sorry, couldn't you see Michael?
Yeah, no, I see him.
He was saying, no, we don't have him.
Because he's racist.
Yeah, it's because you're racist against people that don't wear hats.
That's right.
You hate bald people. You're not bald yet.
Okay, all right.
It's a nice hat. You look great. And it's going to stay on.
No matter
why. Because we do it right. Good night, everybody. Say good night, Bob.